Do you want to know why people keep quitting your network marketing team? It doesn't matter if you are building traditionally, online or both. The issue of poor retention is very real, industry-wide, and its effects can take some very good people out of the game. Nobody likes it when people quit their team, right? It feels terrible and doesn't do much for your bottom line either, does it? So, what on earth can you do about it? There are really three main reasons at play in their decision to do so. 1. Not setting the right expectations. One of the biggest mistakes network marketers make is not setting the right expectations from the very beginning. When you bring in a new customer or business builder, it's absolutely critical to start them off the right way. Ideally, you want them to know exactly what to expect from the experience, the good, the bad, and the ugly. So often, network marketers get so excited, especially when they're new, and they end up overselling the product, service, or opportunity. They can become really hypey and make promises they can't possibly keep. The prospect ends up expecting it to be like utopia, which of course it's not. Make sure to let your new customers and recruits know, realistically, what to expect in 30, 60, 90 days so that you aren't immediately setting them up for failure. That way, there won't be any surprises and your prospects won't end up feeling duped by the whole thing, as so often happens when this step is mishandled. 2. Poor, or non-existent, training and duplication systems. Many network marketing companies, especially new ones, often do not have great training systems. If your company has great training that is proven to work and to duplicate, then, for the love of all that is holy, don't reinvent the wheel. Plug into the system, teach the system and let it work its magic. At all costs, resist the urge to do it all yourself. Your goal is to be as unnecessary to the process as humanly possible. Sometimes that's tough on our egos. We like to be the all-knowing, all-seeing network marketing gods, but that just doesn't serve anybody long-term. Don't do it. If you have the tools at your disposal, by all means, use them and teach your network marketing team to do the same. Unfortunately, if you don't have access to a great duplicatable system, you'll have to create something for your team to plug into. It needs to be really simple and straightforward, so don't get swallowed up in unnecessary details. 3. Poor network marketing team culture. This is, in my opinion, the most important factor to consider if people keep quitting your network marketing team. So many leaders drop the ball when it comes to network marketing team culture. They often focus all of their energy on the producers in the team and forget about everyone else. Don't get me wrong, as a leader, you do have to schedule your time appropriately and your people do need to earn that time. However, the value you attribute to another human being should not be connected to their production numbers.
Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your team members. Also, to get the future video updates, don't forget to subscribe my channel and turn on the bell icon.